and cheese panini.
What is that?
Mortadella and cheese panini. It's like some type of meat. Like a sausage. Apple and browned butter tart.
That sounds amazing.
Butternut squash skillet lasagna.
Ooh. Ooh.
Crispy fried Brussels sprouts with chili fish sauce. It's like an Asian.
Hmm.
Leeks vinaigrette. Brussels sprouts and chorizo beer hash.
Beer hash.
Halloween bark. Persian quince jam.
Don't know about it.
Roasted cauliflower, sage, and almond risotto.
That sounds amazing. I love a risotto.
Seared pork with apples and broccoli.
Oh, please. You liked it. You can do the pork. Like the pork. What did you make?
I just made pulled pork.
No, yeah, but
pork chops.
Pork chops. Those were good. See, I don't even like stuff like that. And then I'm like,
yeah.
Wait, is this what it's supposed to taste like?
Yes.
So good.
Yeah, Mary wanted to be a teacher. We never got around to it, but
I don't need to learn. I just need to eat them.
I can show you.
How about how about you come up with a fall menu and I'll partake.
Menu.
You can make, you know, enough for everybody, but
yeah. Oh, okay. I was just trying to find one recipe for the newsletter.
Sure, October, but I mean, it's a twofer. I love a good twofer. Oops. What?
I need to get you one of those.
Same thing. I'm feeling
what's those things?
Yeah.
What are called? The boards.
But this was up a lot higher, just so you know. It was up.
It was totally crooked.
No, it was up. And it slowly.
You're trying to get me again.
It's like.
You.
It's really more. It's I.
Okay. Good thing we're just talking about
we're just
food.
Listening. Look, it's no, still not right.
Okay. Kale, cranberry, and sausage stuffed acorn squash.
Are you trying to say you think I'm fat?
But what did you say? Are we done talking about the pork? Do you want to do seared pork?
Yeah.
The pork chops?
Do you know about, do you know how to make risotto?
Yes.
Well, I don't.
Okay.
So,
would you like me to teach you?
No. I just want to eat it in the fall menu.
Okay. So, risotto and pork chops. What else?
I don't know why you're not writing it down. But it was like a risotto, like, it said a cauliflower, but I could see like a risotto with like a squash or something.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't that
like
sound good?
Like a butternut squash risotto?
Yeah. Then with like a pork chop
some maple
with
syrup.
Like, yeah, and a pork chop with like some applesauce type of a, I love an apple with a pork.
It'll be.
Or pear. That's what I've done before. Pear.
It'll be like this. See the apple slices in with the, or no, you went on the side.
Screw it. I'm out. I'm just kidding. Yeah, whatever. I have no frame of reference.
Okay. Carrot cake with brown butter cream cheese frosting.
I love your carrot cake. Was that what you made before?
Yeah,
what was
but it didn't have brown butter cream cheese frosting. It was just white. It was white.
Don't talk it down.
Cream cheese frosting.
Oh, that cream cheese frosting was.
Yeah. So this will be brown butter. So you browned the butter.
I'm not sure I'll be able to tell the difference. I'll just
it'll
be inhaling
like,
all of it.
It'll be more like a caramely cream cheese icing over that carrot cake.
I'd like a creme brulee icing, please.
Okay. Do you have a blowtorch?
I just want it flavored creme brulee.
Well, I need a blowtorch.
I can figure it out.
Okay. Ready? This is one of my absolute favorites, but with shrimp.
I gotta put on my list. DIY blowtorch.
Yes, thanks. Thai chicken and coconut. I love Thai shrimp and coconut soup.
Why can't I have that right, like, now? Like, can you have it in 5 minutes? Like,
nope.
What is...
We need to go to
it's Friday, though. What?
Ka-ching. Let's see. Nope. Didn't happen.
Dang it.
Roasted garlic and parsnip soup with lemon sage butter.
I don't even know what you just said.
Stuffed pears and... fruit? That's a pear stuffed
fruit.
Cheese. Wrapped in puff pastry and drizzled with honey.
You know what that sounds like? That sounds like baklava. Sort of like a, you know, like the puff pastry with like the honey.
Yes,
and
yes, but there's no nuts here. And it's not, it's just a full pear.
But what you need
do
to know.
Want to do that?
Yes. Yes. But what you need to know is I love baklava.
Okay. Then here we go, right here. Sweet potato gnocchi.
Gnocchi?
Gnocchi.
Have you ever done...
What was that one thing we did that one time?
Just think it's... What was that one thing we did that one time? No, I know what it was.
We've done many things.
Dumplings. Could we ever get back to the dumplings?
The chicken and dumplings?
Yes.
You want some?
Oh. Don't you remember?
Yeah, of course I remember. The dumplings. You like the chicken?
Give me a minute. I gotta go to the bathroom. Did someone say dumplings?
Maybe that could be our recipe.
Yeah.
Chicken and dumplings. That's a good October.
It is. One. It is. I knew there was something. Yeah, it was good. Put down Now here's my marketing. My marketing self is, sometimes if you think to yourself, like, what's a really hot item, you know?
You have a waffle iron. Mashed potato, cheddar, and chive waffles.
That sounds amazing, but you're going to like this even better. Maybe we could turn this into a waffle. Well, I don't know if you know this, but real big right now, especially in Philadelphia, is the cannabis market. So, as a marketing person, if we want to just make this month's newsletter, you know, just to get people interested and noticed, you know, I mean, forget the fact that we don't have anything to do with cannabis. We don't know where to find it. We don't believe in it. We don't know where the medical, you know, forget all that. But it's like the hook, you know, to get them in. So this is just hear me out. This month, cannabis tea, cannabis, I mean, not the brownies, something real, you know what I mean? Work it like cannabis, dumplings.
Risotto.
Sorry. Oh, sure. Like,
it'll look like oregano.
That's what I'm saying. Yep. So just be thinking outside the box because we're going to market this thing hardcore, okay? Mm-hmm. Hashtag marijuana. You know what I mean? So it's like before you get like the moms and dads, you know, you might get the kind of people you would expect to get on a newsletter. Forget that. We just want to blow this newsletter out of the market. We want so many eyeballs on this thing.
Okay.
We might even want to consider a racy photograph. As the just really secure the deal.
Okay.
Like a story, like this mother grows it in her kitchen, and then we've obscured her face, you know, and then we just go to the schools and just ask around.
Okay.
It's just a thought. If we really want to market this thing hard, I mean, you just do. It's a simple formula. Forget what we're about. Just go for the numbers. No, seriously, it's like I start thinking to myself, because marketing-wise, you know, I mean, you would go for you try to include things that are already popular, like the seasonal, the farmers markets, like, and then you would include...
How about maybe once every, how about bi-weekly we do...
How about a local...
A cooking thing.
Oh, sure. That's a blog. A cooking
like
blog?
A cooking blog or that's something a good idea. Related to get us.
I think that's a good idea. And we could even do it like here at the table.
Yeah.
Like, and then, yeah, I mean, or the prep part of it or something. Or whatever, wherever we did it before. Yeah, I like it. But you're going to have to come up. No, I like it because here's the thing. If we're going to keep doing, it'll help keep us on top of the editorial calendar. Mm-hmm. And it will give us something to actually write about, and then it'll give us content. Like if there's an actual video, then it needs to work together.
And especially if it's the e-newsletter, there can be a link to the video of us making the recipe that's on.
Exactly. So it works. It's not like extra work. It's like work that would.
And then it would be
also
our lunch, or dinner for our family.
Right.
So it's like win-win.
Exactly.
All the way
that's the whole. See that that fits the guidelines of Real Life Matters, because you're doing real life and then you're finding a way to share it with others. Mm-hmm. That's the Real Life Matters way.
It is. New.
Yeah.
And exciting.
I like how you say it. Like,
never been done before.
Yeah.
Because today starts now.
So I'm thinking,
what's your mind?
Everything starts today or something like that. Everything, today is everything or something like that. I'm actually gonna, I always have like 12 different beverages. I do, it's like, I'm like, make sure you get your water, and then I'm like, make sure you get your meal, AKA my smoothie, and then I always have to have the coffee that I never finish, and then, you know what, I'm gonna switch over to the tea. It's right at about 2. Oh, I gotta take my 2 p.m. Energize. I gotta take it like it's this. You gotta have my bottle.
Okay, so I feel like I have the recipe covered now for the newsletter.
Okay, so can you get out at 8:30 by 11?
I'm gonna then move along to fun activities. Should it just be one fun activity or a list of several?
You're gonna have to answer that question right now for yourself. And let me know what you answer. And it better be freaking good. Don't let me ever see you put any fewer than one tea bag in your tea. You understand? That is just
peer pressure.
No, I'm just saying it's the right way to do it.
I only like one tea bag.
Huh?
Nothing.
You really do like it? Seriously?
It depends on what kind it is, actually. If it's the lighter tea, then two. But if it's like something more strong, I use
one. Right, okay, I can see that.
It also depends on the size of the mug. So this is a smaller mug. If it's like one of those.
Oh my gosh. I got some good ones today. I got some good yogi vibes.
Yay.
Create the sequence of goodness. Consequences will always be good. And the other one is develop the power of, what is it?
Positivity.
Listening.
Yeah.
What? Yep. Wait. Did someone say there's power in it? Wait.
There's
power. This changes everything. Why did you say so?
There's power in the listening?
I didn't know that. No one told me. You never told me.
Yeah, so I love to listen.
Oh, sure. Now you're making me look bad. My one from yesterday, and I forgot to say it. People... Listen to this. People who love are happy. Not people who are loved, people who love are happy. And the other one is, the beginning is you, in the middle is you, and in the end is you. I can see you're confused.
Okay.
But the point of that is like, so you're like, what's the plan? Where are we going? What are we doing? It's like, I don't know, but you'll be there the whole way. So just ask yourself when you get there.
Oh my gosh.
You know?
I'm learning to just enjoy the journey.
I'm not shaming you. I'm just drawing the connection. That's all.
But yeah. Okay.
Really tempted to pull that one thing out of the trash can and put it on my.
What thing?
It's like the outer cover to your planner.
I was like, that might be pretty. She just ripped that off and threw it away.
Yeah.
I was like, I keep wanting to dig in there, but there's like tea bags and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and I'm gonna work right along.
Well, thanks for sharing. Wait, what is it you're doing again?
I'm trying to sign off because it's time.
Oh.
So, goodbye, people.